It's also a process.
当然我也认识他们很早，他们，我觉得他们两个人特别有一种勇气，就是一直在，从事这种策展和展览的实践。那么这个过程呢，他们不光是他们的展览，而且他们跟
these projects and curate things of maybe artists and about things that are new to them and that they don't necessarily understand that well. So their process has also been a exploration and learning experience.
那么实际上文学呢，可能是我们只是在语言文字上更抽象。更具有想象力，那么视觉又是更具体，它形象化，所以这是二者之间的一个不同的功能。但是这一次这个展览把它串起来，我觉得这是一个非常把它这个粘接起来，我觉得是一个很重要的。
So words in many ways are the most abstract of all things, whereas a piece of visual art is.Even if it's abstract, it's quite concrete. It's there in front of you. So what I found very important about this particular exhibition was to bring together these two things and try to amalgamate them.
那么我们如果回到这个主题上，就是回归奥德赛，那么实际上它是揭示的人性的一个东西。我自己觉得，我自己的解读就是人性。不过人性我想是不管在古代还是现在都是贯彻其中的。
So if we return to the main theme of the exhibition of the Odyssey and Ulysses and this, it's about people, and it's about kind of people as they change and transform.
那么我自己觉得有，因为可能有的朋友可能看着咱有点有。可能对视觉文学很容易理解，但是视觉艺术不能理解。那么实际上呢，我想这个现在的视觉艺术，它的表现的方法已经不同于那样的传统的叙事了。它用这个，比如说 collage 或者是 pastiche 这样的方式，就是拼贴或者是，那么就打破了那个过去那样一个单一的，就是叙事。
So the also interesting in this particular case is that we're exploring.Mediums that are non-traditional or new in the sense that in the past visual art was just there, a painting, but now we're talking about pastiches or collages, mixed media, different things being kind of pasted together.
但是我觉得最重要一点还有就是说除了这个方法以外，我觉得还有关注的角度，比如说我觉得飞扬作品你可以去理解，比如说像这样一个大的作品，你可以理解成这是一个眼睛看到的世界，你也可以理解成是一个望远镜，你也可以理解是一个别的啊。所以我想，今天的视觉艺术并不是给你一个唯一的答案，它给你更多的想象力。
Another thing that he found very interesting in this is perspective. So if we look at this large work, it's round and it could be like what you see out of your eye.Or it could be what was seen out of a telescope, or it could be something else. It's really uncertain, so it kind of it opens up a lot of possibilities.
但是他的作品里边，我觉得不仅仅是这样一个看凝视与被凝视的关系，还有一些很复杂的东西，比如说移民问题，比如说这个 nomadic 就是流动性。游牧性，比如说这个主体性 identity 等等，这样的议题都在这个作品里面能反映出来。
And also, it's not a simple kind of question that's being asked because there's a lot of different content in there, relating to identity, relating to place, relating to movement.
所以我自己觉得就是我在写这个文章的时候我也谈到就是说今天我们也知道这个我们生活在这个地球上我们尤其是知道这个世界不仅仅是我们自己我们知道的更外部的世界有紧密的联系。
A more flexible, a more open kind of perspective when walking around and just don't look at it as being like a painting. you have to see it for what's behind it.
比如说我们也知道今天的，当然这个从艺术视角的这个2060年代以来，这个艺术的这种媒介的扩张一直是不是停滞的，一直在不断的扩张。也就是说我们今天运用这个绘画材料或者综合材料越来越的可能性很多，就什么方式都可以去运用进去，只是说方式运用进去以后什么更合理去表现，这个是最重要的。
So, with the development of technology, and there's a never-ending options in terms of medium that can be used. So, there's that freedom in the one sense, but there's also the importance of kind of identifying your message within the medium.
就像那个瑞莲他的肖像一样，他表现的都是那种，像流动一样的感觉。像水一样的感觉，哎，还有糖的这种结合，实际上都是在激活这个艺术本身。我觉得就在激活艺术本体的东西。
So like Nieves works with the sugar and the fact that they're almost like living organisms. He finds that to be very interesting and important in terms of how life is today, with the art reflecting change.
当然还有比如像中国艺术家，像那个格里斯坦的作品，也有这种把这种叙事完全颠倒了，不是我们正常的这种叙事。比如说像那个李新墨的作品里边，也有对这个权力话语，男性的权力话语的这种批判等等。我想这个都在这个作品里面都体现出来。
So he thinks that also like Gulistan's art is also kind of showing change or there are layers to what's being said. And also with Li Xinmuo, she's kind of looking at it from a woman's perspective. And telling a story that maybe is different from what came before. So that's what's important for this exhibition.
我自己觉得其实这个我写的文章只是一个提示，并不能代表我能全部读懂他们的作品。因为我觉得视觉艺术比我的文字更丰富。因为语言说的太具体就把它固定了。视觉艺术很多的空间。
So in terms of what he's written for the exhibition, he regards it as being kind of a catalyst or a reminder, a starting point. Because words are too fixed, and the art is, there's more to it than just what he's been able to write down. So he hopes that you will look at it and use his text as a starting point.
但是我还是觉得这个展览本身它有活力啊，就是五个女性艺术家，她们是不同的角度来揭示不同的问题，把这个展览集合在一起，讨论的是回归奥德赛里边的人性的东西。
But most striking for him is that it's five women who have kind of taken this story and made their own interpretations of it andused Joyce as kind of a canvas to tell their own stories.
So I thank you.
It's about people.